So, last session we saw what is permanent address and what is care of address. So, here you can see when the user, mobile user, moves from one area of the network to the other area, that network is called as visited network. So, when the mobile user visits the other network, the other network is called as a visited network or foreign network. So, now who is responsible here for our mobile user? There is one router. That is called as foreign agent, that acts like a foreign agent. What it will do, it will broadcast about its presence. As soon as the mobile user visits this network, he'll come to know the presence of the foreign agent. So, and he'll contact the foreign agent. So now the foreign agent will issue one address for this mobile user in this network, and this address is called as a care of address. And similarly, same time our foreign agent will contact home agent and inform the care of address of this mobile node and saying that your mobile user is in my area. So at the end, both will know, at the end, both will know about the presence of a mobile node. Now the question comes, how do you contact your mobile friend? If you consider if your friend is frequently changing address from one, how do you find him or her? There is different ways, right? Search all the phone books, call her friends, expect her or him to let you know where he or she is. All these are difficult tasks. So, what is the other way? So, as soon as the user moves from one end to the other end, one network to the other network, the related router will do the changes in the routing table. And there is a different types of mechanism to route the correspondent call. And that mechanism is known as indirect routing mechanism or direct routing mechanism. So here we will now talk about what is indirect routing mechanism and what is direct routing mechanism. So here you can see your home network and the visited network. Here the user left the home network and he visited the foreign network. So here you will get the IP address from the mobile agent, foreign agent, and same will be informed to the home network, to the home agent. Now, at the end, both foreign agent and home agent knows about the mobile location. This is called as mobility registrations. Now, we'll talk about indirect routing. So now our correspondent want to contact our home user, and he will call the home network because he doesn't know whether the user is there in the home network or some other foreign network. But in our case, the user already left the home network and is in the visited network or foreign network. But our correspondent calls the home network, and from the home network, our home agent router knows the presence of our mobile node in the foreign network. So he will contact the foreign agent, and he will contact the foreign agent, and he will send the packet by means of encapsulation to the foreign agent. As soon as the foreign agent receives this packet, he will decapsulate and he will transmit that packet to our mobile node. And now our mobile node contacts the correspondent directly. This is called as indirect routing. See, the routing is something like this. This is called indirect routing because our correspondent has to call the home network. From the home network, call is diverted to the foreign network and from there to the correspondent. So this is called as indirect routing. This routing has got several disadvantages and drawbacks. What is a drawbacks? First of all, this routing is called as a triangle problem. So a triangle problem. Triangle problem because the correspondent cannot call directly to the our user. He has to call the home network from home network to the foreign network and foreign network to this one. Now this is called as a triangle problem. Now, how to overcome this one? That we'll see how to overcome this one in direct routing. So this indirect routing has a triangle routing problem, and this is called as a, this is inefficient and it takes long time. And one more problem is if you think like our correspondent and our visited user are both in the same network, and our correspondent and they are transmitting information by sitting beside each other. But the information moves from our visited user to foreign network to the correspondent. So this is the big disadvantage of indirect routing. So in order to overcome this one indirect routing, we have something called as direct routing. In the direct routing, our mobile user, what is doing our mobile user, sorry, our correspondent, he wants to get the care of address from the home network or home agent. Once he gets the care of address, he will directly call the visited user or our foreign network or foreign agent, and you directly call. So this way, this way it will solve the triangle problem. You can see here, home network, visited network, foreign agent and other entities. So now, one more problem is there. So what will happen if our visited user keeps on changing the foreign network? For there is a solution. Each foreign network contains one more agent that is called as anchor foreign agent. As soon as our visited user leaves this network and if he moves to the other foreign network, this anchor foreign agent will be updated. The anchor foreign agent will be updated with the address of the new foreign agent. So new foreign agent. Now our user moves leaves this network and moves to the other network. Same that address will also be updated with the anchor foreign agent. So that that information will be provided to the correspondent, and correspondent can contact our foreign agent, our user directly. So this is called as a direct routing. This will solve the problem of indirect routing. So with this, we have completed here the concept, something called as cellular internet access and principles and mobility and principles addressing and routing to mobile users. And next few concepts are pending are mobile IP handling mobility in cellular network. We will see it later. Before that, in the next session, I want to give some information regarding the protocol. Thank you.